YouTube. This is your boy, Sherry Speech. Right now, I want to talk to you guys about DC's Legends of Tomorrow, Season 3, Episode 17, guest starring John Noble. And right now, you know, the team just figured out that Amaya went back to 1992 to Zimbezi to save her family, which is a big no-no in this case, because then that means Malice would escape and cause wreak havoc amongst the world, which again is not good at all. And now we see Nora and Malice get, oh my gosh. And now it just grew wings. Okay, now John Noble has to be saved because Grodd wants to kill him. Run Bear. Oh, I'm sorry. Wait, I'm sorry. That's Barack Obama. Oh my goodness. Grodd tried to kill Barack Obama. My goodness. Which is Miles trying to free himself, but to no avail. So I'm eating Starburst all day, my favorite candy. And Damian just realized that if Malice fully awakens, that his daughter will no longer be who she is. They'll no longer be a Nora Dark. It'll just be Malice. And Damian, I don't think he will be able to take that because, you know, that's his little girl, that's his daughter. You know, I don't think any man would be able to trade his own damn daughter for an evil damn entity. I don't think even Damian Dark, as cold as he is, would ever do that. So Damian Dark said, I'll see Malice later. Malice later. And now Damian leaves. So now Raid shrunk Grodd, now I put him in a jar. Grodd said, I'll destroy you, I'm gonna kill you. And now Ray's actually going to keep Grodd, like he's some damn pet. Now we go to Zimbezi 1992, Nate and Wally do. That rhymed. So now, actually, Amaya actually spots Nate. She said, what are you doing here? You know, and Nate said, look, Amaya, I know you're upset with Kwasi's death. I'm truly sorry, but doing this is only going to make history worse. In fact, Amaya does not even blame Nate for her granddaughter's death. She said, like, just stay out of my way. Now, mind you, so now Sarah's talking about Barack. He said, you know, I like Barack better. And now Sarah just cleared his mind. And now Nate just realized that he told Wyatt, listen, we're screwed no matter what we do. Alright, so looks like Damon Darth is with the Legends. I'm sorry, speaking with Sarah and Rip, trying to see if he can obtain his daughter once more. He realizes that the cost of bringing Malice forth sacrifices his daughter. And like I said before, Damon Dark may be cold as hell, but he wouldn't dare sacrifice his own daughter to bring forth a dark entity. This goes to show what kind of man he actually is. You got my respect, Damon. Word up. Okay, so check this out. So now the legend is trying to help Damien secure his daughter's soul. So then that way he can have his daughter back. Because I like I said, there's no damn way Damien would ever sacrifice his daughter's livelihood for a damned evil entity. What man would actually do that? What father would do that? Not any. That's their cold-hearted motherfuckers. Then they would. Okay, so I just got a new update. It turns out, actually, with the deal with Mollus, Nora actually dies. Which is why, again, Damien is not going to allow that to happen. Which is why he's at the Legends right now asking them to help him. Because he just gave them the damn water totem. Which means, listen, if you guys get all six, you can actually stop the guy. And now Rory wants to fry Damien, but Ray talks, Rory out of him and says, listen, we need to help him get his daughter back. And then that way we can defeat Mollus. So Ryan's like, what the hell are we doing here? We need to stop the mine, not party with the village. Because they're actually at one of Maya's family gatherings, I believe. Oh wow, so that's Maya when she gets older. She looks beautiful. And see, the thing is, Nate realizes that when Maya goes back to Zimbezi, those two never grow old together. Nate and Maya, I mean. And now Maya's speaking to her family to cast the totem. Now it's my own daughter. Make way. The new protector of Zimbezi. So now we see a little girl walk up with a baby. So now Kawasa tells Amaya that her mother's not coming. Her mother has chosen to reject her destiny and duty. I'm sorry. Now, mind you, the younger Maya is there as well. In fact, she just walked off. So, with Amaya convincing her daughter not to accept the totem, it stops the war from happening. It stops the warlords from coming to Zimbezi and wreaking havoc on her family, thus killing her and ruining her family forever. But then also securing a future, I guess, for her daughter and her granddaughter. So Nate's like, look, you go talk to your daughter, now go talk to the older you. Maya's like, thank you, Nathaniel. So Wally's just like, wait. It's like, we're doing what? I'm sorry for the stutter. I had to get that out. And so Sarah's just sitting there and realizing how much it took for her not to kill Damien Darhk, considering all that he's done to her. I mean, let's look at the track record here. She's killed He's killed her sister, ruined her, completely ruined her psyche, and almost ruined, took her soul away to summon Malus. I'd say that's a lot to kill the guy. I mean, especially the first one. Okay, so Sarah just gave a pretty big update on Ava. You're afraid of what you might find out if you confront Rip about what he knows about you. And of course, of course, Ava's just like, well, what more is there to find out, Sarah? Even Rip comes through. Right now, he's talking with the two of them. Okay, so Ava goes to Barack Obama for some advice to make a rational decision on whether or not she should kill Damon Dark or not. Even Barry's like, I don't know, it sounds human. I'm not at best at that a demon. That the girl is at best to stop a demon. I'm gonna miss you. And then she just zaps him. Oh my goodness. Sarah is a real one. Sarah literally said, look, check this out. I don't believe that you've changed because you're still the same son of a bitch, cowardly son of a bitch that put an arrow through my sister. So after that's over with, I'm putting your ass back in the ground where you belong. And even Damien was like, deal. So it's only problem, y'all. After they defeat Mollusk, she's putting him back in the damn ground where he belongs. You know what? I'm not even mad at that. But you know, I will say this: my opinion of Damon Darth has changed. I mean, he has shown to be a better person. I should say, a humanized person at best. You know, because you know his daughter over everything. You know what I'm saying? So, I'll say this: I respect Damon Dark a lot more. There, I said it. All right, y'all. So before Nate goes to talk to old Amaya, Wally just has to reassure him and check him real quick. He says, "Listen, man, I just want to make sure you're thinking with a clear head here because I know you love her and all, but man, just realize that one mistake that you make could ruin this whole thing, and I won't hesitate to stop you, man." And the old Amaya, her totem lit up and. Now she's trying to subdue Nate. So now Nate's like, she's like, Maya's like, wait, who are you? And Nate's like, yeah, you know, we used to spend travel time together. So now Nate shows Maya the picture that he has up on their phone, his phone. To keep my promise to you. So nowadays, about to explain to Amaya why he's here. Hair's always in the clouds. She didn't show up to her own ceremony. She doesn't know what she wants. You had a hard time proving that when you were her age, too. Look. Yes, you believe that you were believed the same of her. She would accept it, so, without a doubt. Even Amaya, she, talking to her daughter, said, "You have the strength of me and everyone else stronger than ever before." Alright, so now Damien shows up to his daughter, and she's like, she's mad as hell. She's like, "You failed me. You didn't set the master free." And so now Damien's like, "Well, maybe Miles can talk to you and let him know how he feels." And Damien's like, "Wait a minute. Wait, really? Miles is speaking to you? Gotta hope Red's technology does not mess up." Your father believes you today. Why is that splinter? I wonder what it is. I would in a heartbeat. I love how David is just playing this off, man. He's really good at this. So now the plan works, and now they're on the Wave Rider. Jones should be around here somewhere. Yes. What is this? I'm sorry, but this is for your own good. So now Nora awakens Miles, and she's pissed. But you know what, like Damien said, it's for your own good, sweetheart. Plus, that's your damn daughter, bro. I mean, who wouldn't want to go and, you know, help his daughter out? Okay, so now Damien Dark is taking the time to tell and admit to his atrocities as a father. I was a terrible father. I died and I leave you, and I left you all alone. Trapping you in my foolish dreams. I treated you like a demon. I was a demon to you way before Miles did. So don't let him allow you to take you away from me. Your daughter is gone. No. For her soul. Her flesh. It was really. And so now I know for a fact that Damien Darth would really whoop Miles' ass if he had to for his daughter. Which is why I respect Damien Darth so much more. So now Ava said, "I know I'm a clone rib. So why me, huh? Of all new clones in 2023, why me? You're special. So why'd you erase my memory? Yeah. It'd be easier. Easier for you, easier for me. You're too critical to this mission. Excuse me, Carnac. You can just get another one. You can save me to 2213, you get another one. I wasn't even the first one, was I?" 12. So what are your first choice? You don't understand. You're exceptional to me. Just don't. Damn it, Rip, why do you have so many damn secrets, bruh? Seriously. Like, here's my question to Rip. Who are you protecting? I know you had a bar to break. Or was it the night you were murdered my sister? Look, what I did was unforgivable. And I have another to do because I didn't know I can understand the pain I caused. I would, if I could take it all back, I would. Worst of us can make anyone. I committed this job. We joked and see you. Yes, but you did. You wanna lie? Say words about it. Speak my guts to someone who wants to kill me. Only 10,000. Enough, Sarah. Because people like us, whatever you are from the darkness. So when the warriors come, so when the warlords come tomorrow, she'll be ready. Amaya's daughter will be ready, which is a great thing, which is what Amaya exactly wanted. Thank goodness. So don't you want to stick around for a bit? One of the legends, one of the ideas. My favorite race time memory. Racing you would be the only way to save my people. In hindsight, I'd always be persuading you. Probably would be in love with you. Alright, so Wally goes back to the Wave Rider and tells the team about what's happening, unbeknownst to them that everything is alright. So Sarah's like, listen, you can't fight what you can't see, but what if the only way to fight to beat Miles is to let him out? And Sarah reminds us, you know, the reason why the original Death Totem Toters failed to beat Miles is because they allowed the Totem to take them over. I'm sorry, they allowed the Totem to betray them. Okay, so now Damien Darth wants to help. He said, because listen, I have a personal stake, but I have a bone to pick with Miles. He took my precious daughter, and I'm going to send him straight to hell for that. Which I, again, respect you, bro. Okay, so now Ava wants to resign. He said, okay, consider this your resignation then. Because Rip wants is allowing the team to do what they please. So Ava's like, listen, all these plans break all the rules. And Tara's like, listen, you have me. And then she kisses her to make her realize that, look, you have me. You don't need just the rules. I have a plan that can save us both. Love you. There's no meaning to love. You're gonna have to let her go, Sarah. I'm sorry. That's gonna be tough. Guys are back, so Maya and Nate, they prepare for the warlords to prepare to come to Zimbezi. Oh yeah, no, Ray and Wally are there to pretty much brief Nate and Maya on their new recent plan, whereas they are going to give us the water totem to free Mollus, so then that way we can set him free and then kill him. Okay, so I think it's water. Okay, so Nate gets the Earth Totem after a little tiny debate with Ray. Okay, so everyone's just prepared for Mollus to make his debut. So Nora appears to Damien. She said, no, not yet. Well, Miles is trying to take him, but still fighting. Yeah, I made a mistake. I'm sorry. Let's see. I just pulled on my heartstrings a little bit. Yeah, just a little bit. Got all the warlords are here, and it's about to be a big ass fight. So. I'm sorry, the daughter. And then Nate's like, "Well, should we help your daughter?" And Amaya's like, "No, Nessie's got this." Here's Mollus. Why did she transform? The warlords are destroying the village. Grodd is free. I need history to run its course. Son of a bitch, now Grodd is out. What a bitch. So, Damon's not feeling the whole everyone trying to stop him from saving his daughter thing because. So now we see Nessie going up against Grodd. You know, of course, Amaya tried to intervene and try to help her daughter. Damon is not going to take that because he wants to be able to save his daughter. And that's what we understand. We understand something as well that Amaya is trying to save her daughter as well. I mean, she's fighting Gorilla Grodd right now. And so then. Wally tries to take the totem from Damien, but he catches him and almost damn near kills him. So Amaya tries to help his daughter, to no avail. And now Nate comes in and sweeps the rod off his feet, literally. For a totem bear that makes two of us. I wonder to Odomai, does she see Nate as the young guy he is, or as an old version of Nate? So Damien frees his daughter. Performance anxiety, Raymond. You're only proving my point that this plan would never work. And now Sarah stabs Damien. You literally stabbed me in the back. Same seemed fitting. And then Damien's like, I'm not gonna let Nora take down Mollis. And Mollis is coming out. Finally, I am free. Oh, wow. So is this going to be a two-parter? Oh my gosh, that's what Mollis looks like. And I would be shocked too, because it's the fact that he looks. Oh wow. And he's going to fly away. Oh wow. Well, sorry, Damien. Sorry that had to happen. So now they're back to the Old West. This is the season finale, actually. To take down Mollis. Well, that's from trailers next week is the season finale. This is your boy Sheriff Speaks. Make sure you guys like the video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you guys comment what you guys think about the video in the comment section below. If you have any suggestions as to what you guys want me to react to or review, just let me know in the comment section as well. I love you guys. God bless.